So we're in the teeing area at number 16 at Lahontan with my buddy Blakey.
Hello.
Differences between match play and stroke play. And you might have seen players that end up teeing their ball up slightly forward of the marker, which in this case is the little head of the fish here, the Lahontan fish, which is a trout, which is kind of cool, cool name. And logo.
I think you can catch some in the creek on the lake on 12.
You can actually fish here for trout, Lahontan trout, which is pretty cool. So if I'm playing match play where I have an opponent and I tee this up accidentally or maybe intentionally forward of these markers, which would mean I wasn't in the teeing area, my opponent may ask me to cancel this shot. So maybe I hit a great one 3 feet from the flag on this par three, and he says, oh, Marcella, you're right in front of the area. You did not hit from the teeing area. I'm gonna have you cancel that. In that case, I'd be mad at him, but it's okay, because it's within the rules of golf, and I would have to re-tee it, move it back to, I could substitute a ball, move it back to be within the teeing area, and now I'm still playing my first shot, but now I'm in compliance and I'm hitting from the tee.
Just a small quirk here that if the opponent doesn't recall Marcella, who's the player in this case, doesn't recall her shot, and she hits it OB out of bounds, her last place played was actually outside the teeing area. So she doesn't have that automatic right to go back within the teeing area and tee it up. However, the procedure is that you get to drop within the one club length under that stroke and distance rule. Now, you could choose, or Marcella could choose to drop it outside, or Marcella's just going to choose to drop it inside the teeing area from at knee height. And now that her ball is inside the teeing area, she can tee it up wherever she would like within that teeing area. Because she hit it out of bounds, she gets that stroke and distance penalty, so she'd be hitting her third shot.
So there's normally the ability, if you're hitting from the teeing area, to come back and re-tee. If you're hitting from your teeing area, you can re-tee in your teeing area, which is a nice benefit. But what Blakey is explaining is that I wasn't in the teeing area. I was forward of it. So I lose that ability and I have to take a drop. Some of you think it's not that important where your ball actually is, and you really want to make sure that it is not forward of the forward part of those markers, tee markers. Really kind of key.
The most likely situation where this would actually occur is when you tee off from the red, but you're actually playing the yellow of the day. So if the teeing area wasn't in that one club length, then Marcella wouldn't have that ability to drop it back within the teeing area, which is different to the case here.
And then in stroke play, Blakey, what's the scoop and the difference in stroke play? It's not about your opponent, it's about playing the entire field in stroke play. So the other players that you're with, or your fellow competitors, and their opinion is irrelevant. What do you do if you had teed off in front of the tee marker, not in the teeing area technically? What do you do?
Yeah, so in stroke play, it's a little bit different. There's only one way to start play of a hole, and that is to make a stroke, an intended stroke, at your ball within the teeing area. So if you tee up outside the teeing area, make a stroke, you haven't started the hole. If you have another four shots or you have a hole in one, it doesn't count. None of those strokes count.
That'd be horrible.
So this is why it's important that you tee up within the teeing area to start play of the hole. You cancel that stroke, you get two shots for being an idiot, and you have to tee one up within the teeing area of the hole you are playing.
Looking good, but it might not get there. A little wind. Oh, nice. Good shot. Nicely done.